Assalamu alaikum students, how is you all? I hope that you all are doing great. Welcome to your channel, my D12 Scientific Academy. Today our lecture is related to past paper. It's O-level mathematics past paper, May-June 2019. Okay, I have explained you to question number 20 and today I'm going to explain you question number 21. Students, question number 21 is shapes A and B are drawn on the grid. Here you can see a grid. Assalamu alaikum students, how are you all? I hope that you all are doing great. Welcome to your channel, my D12 Scientific Academy. Today our lecture is related to past paper. It's O-level mathematics past paper, May-June 2019. Students, I have explained you till question number 20 and today I'm going to explain you question number 21. Okay, question number 21 is shapes A and B are drawn on the grid. Here you can see the grid and shapes A and B are the drawn. Part A is draw the image of shape A after a translation with vector minus 4 and 1. So we have to draw the image of shape A after a translation. Okay, and the vector is given, which is minus 4 and 1. So let's draw it. Okay, so from this point, here you can see that 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1 upward. Okay, so you'll put sign here, 4 minus 1. 1, 2, 3, 4 and minus 1 is 1 more upward. Okay, now from this point, here you can see that 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 is this and minus 1, 1 more and upward like this. Now from this point, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 and 1 more and 1 point upward. So this would be the point. Now from this point, 1, 2, 3, 4. And minus 1 is 1 more and upward. 1 more and upward. So this is the point. Now join these 4 points. Okay. So this would be your shape, okay, after translation with vector minus 4, 1. Okay, we are done with part 1. Now come to part 2, part B. Alright, so part B is draw the image of shape A after enlargement with the scale factor minus 1 by 2 and center 1, 0. So center is 1, 0. So 1, 0 means that x is 1 and y is 0. X is 1 and y is 0. So this would be your center, 1 and 0. Now what we need to do is we have to draw the image of shape A after enlargement with scale factor minus 1 by 2. So now we have to do what? We have to draw the image of shape A after enlargement. So what we will do is, okay, so now here the points are given and the midpoint is given, which is 0, 1, which is 1, 0. And now we can give the names and we can give it A, we can give it B, we can give it C and we can give this D. Okay, now from this point, count till A. As there is no left, right, as there is no left, right, so what we will do is, it will come 0 over here, as there is no left, right. Now, from downwards, 1 and 2, till this point, till A, from this midpoint is 1, 2, it's 2. So what you will do is, and it's 2, so you write down minus 2, 1, 2, minus 2. Okay, G. Now let's come to part B. Come to point B. Now point B, to the right hand side, it's 1, 2. From midpoint, it's 1, 2. 1 and 2. Here you can see that. So we write down 2. And now till here, downward 1 and 2. It's minus 2. Now let's come to point C. Alright. Here this is point C. So to the left hand side, it would be 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 and downward 1, 2, 3, 4. It's minus 4. Now till this point, it's from midpoint is, there is no left, right, so you write down 0. As there is no left, right, so you write down 0. And the downward 1, 2, 3, 4. It's minus 4. Okay, now you have found the 4 points. Now you have to multiply these 4 points with the scale factor which is given, that is minus 1 by 2. Now multiply it with minus 1 by 2. Okay, students, remember that you have to multiply 0 with first 0 with minus 1 by 2. When you will multiply 0 with minus 1 by 2, you will get 0. And when you will multiply minus 2 with minus 1 by 2, minus minus is plus, and minus minus is plus, minus 2 minus 1 by 2. So it would be like this, minus 2 minus 1 by 2. Minus minus is plus, and 2 will cut with 2. So you will get just 1. So 0, 1. Now let's come to this. When you multiply 2 with minus 1 by 2, you will get 2, 1s are 2. So you will get and minus 1. So plus 1 multiplied by minus 1 would be minus 1. And when you will multiply minus 2 with minus 1 by 2. Okay. So what you will get? Minus 2 multiplied by minus 1 by 2. So 2 and 2 will be cut, and minus, you will get 0. Okay, you will get 1, sorry. Here you can do like this, minus 2 multiply by minus 1 by 2. So 2, 2 will cut with each other, and minus minus is plus. So you will get 1. Okay, minus 1 and 1. Okay, Gina, let's come to this. When you multiply 4 with minus 1 by 2, 2, 2s are 4, you will get minus 2. And when you multiply minus 4 with minus 1 by 2, so minus minus is plus, and 2 2s are 4. Let's come to this point. When you multiply 0 with minus 1 by 2, you will get 0. And when you multiply minus 4 with minus 1 by 2, minus minus is plus, and 2 2s are 4. Okay, now we can say that this is point A naught, this is point B naught, this is C naught, and this is point D naught. Let's locate them. Okay, the first is 0 and 1. So 0 and 1 will come over here, 0 and 1. So 1, there is no movement left, right, just 1. So you will put the point over here. This is A naught. Now B naught is minus 1 and 1. Minus 1 mean move to the left hand side, 1. 1, minus 1 and 1. So to the left hand side minus 1, and then this one go upward. So this would be the point. This is B naught. Now what's the C naught point? Is minus 2 and 2. Minus 2 mean you have to move 2 points to the left hand side, 1 and 2, 1, 2, minus 2, and upward 2, 1, 2. So this would be the point. This is C naught. And now 0, 2, there is no left, right, just upward. So there is no left, right from midpoint, just upward. So here this is 2. Now let's join these points like this, like this, like this, and like this. Okay, Jay. I hope that part B is clear to you. Now let's move forward to part C. Okay, students, part C is shape A is mapped onto shape B by the single transformation P. Describe fully the transformation P. Okay, Jay. So students, here you can see that and that's transformation B. Here you can see that it's in Y axis. Okay. As you can say that it's in Y axis. Shape B is in the, by the single transformation P is in the Y, is this B is, shape B is in the Y axis in this region. So it's in the Y axis. So we can write down that transformation P is in the Y axis. Okay. The transformation P is in the X axis. It's in the X axis. So we write down the transformation P is in the X axis. You write down the transformation P is in the X axis. This is the X axis region. So write down is in the X axis. Alright. Okay, Jay. Now let's come to second part. Find the matrix representing the transformation P. Okay, Jay. Okay, here you can see that these both are positive. This is 1. And this is also 1. This is also positive. On x-axis, both are positive. And this is B point. B is 3. And from here, this point is also 3. So both are positive. Now there's a difference in y-axis. And on x-axis, both are positive. Okay, now see on the y-axis. On y-axis, it's 4 and minus 2. And it's minus 2 and minus 4. So there is a difference of the signs. Okay, on y-axis, there is a sign. Here the values are negative and here the values are positive. So what will be the your matrix? Okay, so for transformation of P, that how would you find out the matrix representing transformation P? The transformation videos are given on the internet. You can watch and in detail you can and this concept will be clear to you that how to find out the matrix representing transformation P. So here I'm just telling you that as the values on x axis are positive and y axis are changing, so the matrix would be, I will not go into detail, I'll just explain you that you just need to write down the matrix as the values on the axis are positive, so positive to positive and negative to negative. So your matrix would be, it's 1 0 and 0 minus 1. Okay, students, I hope that today's lecture is clear to you. Do the practice of this sum, because when you will do the practice, then this concept will be more clear to you. Take very good care of yourself. Thank you very much. Allah Hafiz.